In this video, I will explain how to do multinomial probability logit models and the conditional logit model in R. Before you watch this video, please make sure that you have watched the lecture as well as the example. So I have opened the R Studio here, and on the right hand side, I have the program already executed. On the left hand side, I have the program open. So in order to do multinomial logit and probability models, you will need the package mlogit. So here under packages, you can do install packages mlogit and then click on install, or you can just go ahead and delete this pound sign here and run this line. Then you need to put the mlogit in the library and read in the data, multinomial fishing one. So let's go ahead and look at the data, and I'm going to open up the data that we have. We have fishing data, and so this data set is specifically done in the wide format, which means there is one row for each individual in the data. And here on the mode is which choice people pick. There are four possible ones, which is beach, pier, private, and charter boat. So these are the possible options, and this is what a person would select. And we will also look at the income that a person has, and this variable income is right here. So it's which mode did they pick for fishing mode, one of the four, and what's the income? That would be the two variables going into the multinomial logit model. So the first thing to do is to describe the data, and we do this with table and mode. And let's see, going back to the beginning of the program. Here is the frequency for each of these categories, and as you can see, charter has the highest frequency, empirical frequency, of people picking this option as the fishing mode. So the next thing that we can do is we can reshape the data from the wide to the long format. And the way to do that is to use mlogit.data, and you read my data. And you're saying which are the variable names from column 4 to column 15. Then you have choice equals mode and the shape equals wide. And that will take it into multinomial logit data. And then we can view the first 20 observations in the long specified. So before we had each person had a row. Now look at this. The first person has four rows of data for them. And that's the first person. These are the four choices that the person could have, and this, the mode is basically, did they pick that choice or not? So the first person picked charter, therefore this is true for them and the rest is false. And for the second person also picked charter, so that's the true choice for them, the rest are false. The third person picked private, so that's a true for them. Notice that we have variables like income that doesn't vary across alternatives, therefore it's repeated across all the alternatives for the same person. And so these are the two variables that we would use for now. Later on in the program, for the conditional logit model, we would also use price, the price of the option, and the catch rate. So these prices would vary. The prices would vary across the options that we have here, as you can see, and the catch would also vary across the options. So actually, yeah, we're not going to use this one. This is the catch rate for the option that they selected. So if you can see, this is the catch rate for this option. And that one was repeated as many times. This one is the catch rate for the option that they selected, and that's repeated for all the options. So we would use these two, the price and the catch, that vary across the options. And that's for the conditional logit model. Okay, so this is how to reshape the data from the wide to the long format. So now, how to do the multinomial logit model? Here's the command for that. You use mlogit. Mode is the dependent variable, and we will not have any variables here that vary with the alternative, so we would put one, the constant. And income would be the variable that does not vary with the alternatives. So we are reading in the data, the long format data that we just generated here. And the reference level would be charter. This would be our base category. And then when we summarize, this is what we see here. So notice that because charter is the base level, we don't have the coefficients for charter here because those are normalized to be equal to zero. We have the rest of the coefficients which are in comparison to charter. So the way to interpret income is that if income increases, then that does not have a significant effect on the probability of choosing beach, then it has the possibility or the likelihood of the individual picking peer goes down, and the likelihood of the individual picking private goes up, so as income increases. And all of this is again with reference to the base category of charter. Okay, now you can also estimate this multinomial logit model if you have a reference level of peer. So in this case, we would have those results right here. And notice that now peer is not in here. So everything is interpreted in comparison to peer. So in comparison to peer, if income increases, then beach becomes more likely, charter becomes more likely, and private becomes more likely to be picked as an option. And so notice that the way that these coefficients are, they don't have any correspondence to the coefficients in the other model, either in terms of magnitude or sign. The next thing that we can do is calculate the multinomial logit model odds ratio, and this is by just taking the exponents of the coefficients for the multinomial logit model. And then we have, these are the odds ratios here, and some fields are using odds ratios. So the way to interpret these is that an odds ratio of over 1 would make that outcome more likely than the other outcome. And likewise, an odds ratio of less than 1 would make this outcome less likely. Okay, so next thing that we will do here is the conditional logit model. The conditional logit model would be also called with the mlogit, with the mlogit command here. We would have mode, and instead of 1 here as we had before, we would put the alternative specific variables here. And then we can have either a charter or a peer or any of the other two categories as base categories. And these would be the results that we see here. Notice that now we have only one set of coefficients for price or catch, but we have multiple sets of coefficients for income. Actually, we have three sets of coefficients because we have four alternatives. So these are interpreted exactly the same way as with the multinomial logit model. And the way to interpret price is that if the price of an option increases, it becomes less likely to be chosen. And if the catch rate increases, it becomes more likely to be chosen. And these have the same interpretations as before. We're looking at the reference is charter. So in comparison to charter, we have that when income increases, the peer fishing becomes less likely, and the private fishing becomes more likely. And same thing again, if we have the base level being peer. So notice that it has absolutely no effect on price and catch. These are our alternative variant variables, but now we would have different different magnitudes and different coefficients on the alternative invariant variable, which is income. Okay, so this is very similar like the multinomial logit model interpretation here. So the next thing to do is how to calculate marginal effects. So the first thing to do here is to set up the mean values for the variables. So here's the model estimated again. And here we have in the data frame, we would get the mean for the price and mean for the catch and mean for the income across all variables. And so we would use these mean values to calculate the marginal effects. So you calculate the marginal effects by using effects, then you give it the results that we estimated from right here. And then covariate incomes income and data equals z. So this z is now the average values that we have here. And these would be the effects that we get from the conditional logit model. And now notice that we have quite a few of them here because for each option that we have for the price and for the catch, we would need to calculate the likelihood on charter. So notice that across the diagonal we have negative ones. So if the price of charter increases, then charter becomes less likely by 0.06%, and so on. But if the prices on the other option increase, then charter becomes more likely by these percentages. And likewise for the price, we have positive values here. So if for the catch, we have positive values here, which means that if the catch increases for a given option, for the charter, the likelihood of someone selecting charter becomes 8.8% more likely. And if the catch rate for the other option increases, then the probability of someone selecting charter becomes less likely. So we have a 4x4 matrix of marginal effects. So you can also calculate, so you can also calculate the marginal effects for the other variables, including income. And income would only have income would have four marginal effects. So that's, we interpret this exactly the same as the multinomial logit marginal effects here. Okay, so the last thing that we are going to do here is we can calculate the Hausmann-McFadden test of independence of irrelevant alternatives. So the way to estimate is we can calculate, we can estimate the multinomial logit model where we have the same reference level, okay, and income would be our independent variable. And now we could estimate the same model where we would have alternative subset only three of the four options. So in the first one we have all four options, and the second one we on purpose miss one of the options. And then we are calculating this test value here, and we have a p-value that's less than 0.05, and therefore we have that the IIA property is rejected. Okay. So this is how you can do this test. Okay, so this is how to do the multinomial probit and logit models in R, as well as the conditional logit model in R. Thanks for watching.